What you got? What you got for Dante?
What y'all feel about this coming to America?
I mean,
gone queen to be.
First of all, because let me tell you, you better not come in here saying nothing bad about no coming to America. That's not the first. This one right here.
That's my favorite.
His fan number one. He was the one out front of the movie selling the t-shirts.
Yeah, that
was Raw wedding t-shirts in the movie.
Step up, get Raw to get a t-shirt.
Yeah, that was me. I look younger than I really am. No, I'm about to be 70 next
and
week.
I gave it another look too. Yeah. Because I didn't see nothing wrong with it the first time, but I'm like, you know, let me really just enjoy the second time going on, knowing what they're gonna do. And I thought that it was a good movie. I'm just leaving it alone. I'm not gonna do nothing bad to it today on the Tap In podcast, okay? Right. Okay. Because it was fine. What you finna say was wrong with it, Dante? You're getting
like
a look.
I didn't like it.
Why?
So Here's I feel like it was too going for the funny too much. You know what I mean? Instead of making a good movie, I feel like they were trying to go for the joke, and it wasn't as because the way I seen Coming to America, one is it was a prestigious movie. It was a fish out of water movie. Yeah, that's where the jokes were, and that's what made it funny to me.
Right.
You know what I mean? But this one, it was like Wesley Snipes coming down the aisle, like he's shucking and jiving. This ain't royal to me. I don't care if he is the bad royal person.
Right.
They all present themselves as dignitarian, as you know, mean like. Yeah. And I was like, and then shout out to everybody that was in the movie. The production of it, the costumes,
it was dope. Yeah.
All of that shit was dope. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I just felt like the story was lacking a little bit, and I was like, man, like this could have been a dope movie. But I just felt like it was too much of we going for the joke versus trying to just make a good movie. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And sometimes I feel like you trying to go for the joke and it just makes it not funny. But when shit happens like accidentally, then it's like, oh, okay, yeah, that's funny.
I mean, my whole favorite part of the whole movie was Leslie Jones lighting that candle.
Leslie Jones was the best one.
I hope you like her. Pumpkin pie. She about to get a whole slide. Then she did them coochie wafts. You know what I'm saying?
She was probably the most natural because she's still like the rawest as far as people that we know. She's not really starting out. And I think that everything that you said is absolutely true. I do. But I do think that it was important that we get a nice, wholesome, can't nobody touch it for no type of stereotypes movie also, which we don't have. Like if you scroll right now on TV Guide or whatever, I don't know, whatever people watch movies on, it's just white people get a chance to do a funny movie, a stupid movie, a romantic movie, a scary movie, a movie where everybody dies, a movie where there's a serial killer. And we try to, you know, we have a game called One's Gotta Go. We try to do royal movies because we tried to talk about the show list. We got this and Black Panther. Like we literally
looked
it up. And
Eddie Murphy said the same thing
yesterday
on the
interview. But we weren't going there. Okay.
There was no animals in
there. Okay. But that's what it is. Like honestly, we don't even have nothing. We don't even have a handful of things that we can go to in any genre, which with any white movie, you have probably at least 10, and that's lowballing.
Yeah.
And so like I said, I did enjoy the wholesomeness of it. They didn't let anybody really do anything. Even the stereotypes they did have, like the baby mama type stuff, they did a lot of breaking with that too by letting the queens get along.
Yeah.
Letting the kids end up eventually getting along. Mm-hmm. So that is, like I said, I don't mind a little corny. I really don't. Like I do get everything that you're saying. But and again, like I said, but I do not mind a little bit of corny. And also I will say, it is very hard for them to make jokes that we think are funny anymore. Like I just recently rewatched all the seasons of Def Comedy Jam, and I'm just like, damn, some of these jokes like were really just coming out. And since then, it ain't been nothing new. Yeah. And you can even go a step further. Like when things started changing in the 90s, where you could be just really raunchy and it wasn't so political, it wasn't so politically driven. It wasn't so like we done had stuff the way we have for a little while. We kind of got a little more stuff that's funny and everyday to us now. Like none of those jokes there's no more original jokes. Like it ain't no stand-up that you're looking for that you cannot find that they were doing it for the first time on that Def Comedy Jam stand-up. Yeah. So them even trying to introduce something that we think is going to be as funny as Coming to America, that shit ain't happening.
Yeah, and
it ain't happening.
I think I had to go into it, if I'm being honest, because it ain't never changed. You know, that's always been my favorite movie, the original, right? I just went in. In my mind, I knew there was no way for it to top the original. It don't matter what they put on the screen, right?
Yeah, right.
So I knew it wasn't going to top it. So once I kind of removed expecting it to top it, then I could kind of enjoy, I enjoyed it. You know what I mean? Like, it was funny. It was a good movie. If it was, even if it was a separate franchise, everybody was like, oh, that movie was good as hell. You know what I mean? But mm-hmm. it was because it came behind the original that people were like. So if you take that out of it and watch it again, you'll enjoy it more. I feel like you'll enjoy it more.
I tried to watch it again. I tried to watch it again. I got like halfway through and I was like, I mean,
it's definitely not an over and over like the original. I don't feel like.
Wish they would have came with a whole different kind of like storyline. You know what I mean? Like, if they would have went back to even trying to get what was the princess that married Eddie Murphy?
Vanessa Bell Calloway, Imani.
Imani. If they would have went back or even dove into trying to move her family to come to America, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think that would have been a dope little storyline where it wasn't about the marriage. You know what I mean? It would have just been trying to get going back in her family and trying to get them to be royal now, because now she's a royal princess, right, and adapting them to the life. I would have loved to see that part of it.
You know what they could have did? They could have made it where, okay, now Lisa didn't move to Zamunda, right?
Yeah.
Now what they didn't realize is that Lisa hadn't paid her taxes in the past few years, and she didn't file none of her McDowell's checks, right? Now they got to go to America to make sure this nigga don't end up, you know what I mean, on the no fly list, right? So they go back to America to keep Lisa out of jail.
Okay, this is another thing black folks do. Yeah. Can always do it better, okay? Listen, ain't nobody else got no script for Coming to America 3 yet, okay?
I got you.
So we did, and I'm telling you, like, we got to let Coming to America come in here so we can keep on with whatever we want to do. You know what I mean? Because, I mean, we know Tyler Perry is the king of getting it.
Please,
but I am not personally a Tyler Perry fan, but I'm not saying that's right. Like, I do need to give him more chance because he is the only one that's kind of taking this risk and doing this stuff. And he don't give us everything. He gonna give us the dumb comedy. He gonna give us some suspense. Now, he gonna be the lead in all of them. Yeah, okay? The romantic lead. He gonna be the heartthrob. He gonna be the murderer.
Alex Cross.
Don't do it. We're not doing it. Okay. We're not doing it. Right, but the point is he trying.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So I'm talking about, I'm slapping myself on the hand and going to watch Alice Cross tonight.
Don't do it.
I'm not. Okay. That's okay. We're pugging tonight. So I'm